Friday. Turn the ball off.
Now they can call any play they want on that play sheet because the elements are not going to play a factor. So it's going to be exciting.
He's just going to feed it off to CJ Anderson. CJ Anderson. Good.
Anderson's handed the football.
God dang, he just flung me, boy.
Well, when you're going to run the football, that's your objective. You cannot get frustrated by short runs. You know that it's going to build itself as the game goes along, so keep trying. Sanders is gone.
Dang, they fight. Everybody fine.
I know it looks easy, but it's not. But a nice throw on the slant route. Slant route means you're slanting towards the inside. Good throw and catch.
First down at the 42. CJ Anderson with the catch. Just inside the 40 at the 39. We'll send it back to the quarterback out of the gun.
Locked on it. Oh, he snagged on him. He snagged on him. Good play by Owen Daniels. Let's go.
Nice job that time of the tight end makes the catch. And you got to look out for him now in the NFL. Remember, they're usually the closest receiver to the quarterback. Quarterback gets in trouble, he's going to look for the tight end.
Andre Caldwell has the catch.
Andre Caldwell. Andre Caldwell.
He heads to the sidelines,
Andre Caldwell.
You got to be agile when you make these kind of catches. One of these short drag routes across the field. That time we saw the agility of the receiver. Nice catch.
Here's the first snap after the big play. Toss play. This will be second down. Defense ready in the goal line formation on this one. Toss to the out over the line. Touchdown. The lead.
Okay. Defense. Get it. Point. Now we gotta come back and score.
Last time they had it, all the way down to the end zone for the touchdown. Yeah, you know, this game, Jim, it's all about momentum. And when you feel you got the momentum on your side, you gotta take advantage of it. So now I think it's up to the offensive coordinator to call the right play. He is a good runner with the football. Not like most quarterbacks in the National Football League. They design runs for him just to do it as a running back.
The Broncos have it at the 29. Got drilled as he throws it.
This great by Anderson the corner for the Minnesota Vikings.
Throw it to the outside. They've got the hook up. That's his
great TV toe catch.
When the defense
it looks like John White Rooster has already had 1,000 rushing yards.
Where the receiver's cutting towards
I mean, 1,000 passing yards. And, he's a rookie. A rookie, people. A rookie.
Sharif Floyd with the sack.
Nice job that time by the defense getting the sack. The blitz was well-timed. And when it's well-timed, the offense doesn't have time to react, and they get a good sack.
They'll go ground. Anderson's tackle at the 43.
This is one good tackling defense. They stay in good position at all times. And we saw it that time, and they stopped the play for a short game.
The Broncos take it from the 40. Room to work. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field. The Broncos
take
down and on the pink. And we see pink throughout the building.
Cover two. They can cover two. They can cover two. Look for Carlo.
With that one. After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down. The Broncos come to the line and they put their receivers in a bunch formation. Scanning the field. Now on the move. He
Why didn't Sarko move? Why did you move towards
him? In a situation like this, Jim, and you get third and long, I'll tell you what catches a defense by surprise. Run a double move on the outside against the defensive back, because everybody in the stands and the defensive players all think you're going to throw it short. He's wide open for the grab. When you can throw an out route like that, that shows you the strength of the quarterback's arm. The Vikings lined up in the nickel. First and 10. Here's the handoff. Joseph's the one who brings him to the ground. Ball's never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game. Halftime, 2 minutes away. We're back, and we're coming out of the two-minute warning in the first half. Second down and 7. Almost intercepted that time. Things get tight down here in the red area. I got to give the defensive man a lot of credit, though. In position, sees the ball thrown, and is able to get that hand up there and knock it down. Third and 7. Demaryius Thomas with the grab. And that's a gain of 10. That's his first reception today. How about the way he always locks in and concentrates on the catch?
James got hands like glue. When you shake his hand, he can break yours, because that's how strong they are. So not surprised to see him just reach out and just snatch the football out of the air. Quarterback should have never thrown at that time. Even though he completes the pass, he should have seen the defense was right there. A loss of a couple of yards.
Loss of 3 on the play. From the shotgun. What a catch. Touchdown. And that. The Broncos' offense looks unstoppable. Touchdown drives the last 2 times they've had it. Here they go again, Phil.
Yeah, they've been very good, Jim. They're taking advantage of situations and scoring touchdowns, and we know that's what you must do. If you don't get these touchdowns, what happens late in the game, it always comes back to bite you. Got to give the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Jim? They are all over the receivers, all over the field, nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion.
Anderson's taking the handoff. Breaks at the tackle. Smith's there to take him down.
Good job of the defensive line standing in there and fighting, and they hold the running back to a short gain.
Following the run, it's now 3rd and 7. This will most likely be the final play before the half ends. The Broncos signal for the timeout, and that's the first one they've used. Offense getting set now following the timeout. 3rd down on the way. The Broncos come out in a jumbo set. Takes off with it. Space to work. The tackle is made, and that's a 3. That'll do it. Welcome back to Sports Authority Field at Mile High. Jim Nance, Phil Sims, and Danielle Bellini here for the start of the second half. The Broncos come out to open up the second half, and they were hitting on all cylinders in the first half, Phil.
Yeah, be smart here in the second half, Jim. When you start out, just find out what the defense is thinking, and once you get a feeling about what they're going to do, then you start taking some chances. Keep the momentum on your side. You got a lead here in the second half. Nice play that time. You pick up the first down. Let's see if you can take advantage of it.
First down on the way.
You can see everybody's wearing pink. Breast cancer awareness. Most of the NFL is supporting.
It's away from pressure.
Feet, breast cancer awareness.
Airing it out. And it falls incomplete.
Beautiful throw down the field by the quarterback, but he just overthrows the receiver just by a couple yards, but a very good try.
The Broncos take it from the 43. Scans the field. 2 hands on the football and has the catch. Steps out.
Why did he step out?
A lot of people talk possession. Sometimes it's overblown, but in a situation like this, where you're winning a close game in the second half, you want to control the tempo, control the clock.
John Franklin was like, he is the leader of this offense. He's leading the offense down the field for a scoring drive every single play. Oh, he short for that thing.
Lots of ways to attack cover two. There's no doubt about it. You can throw it underneath. You can pump fake the safeties, make one of them move, and still throw it deep down the field.
Second and 10. And the reception by Anderson.
Okay. Anderson, okay. CJ Anderson. He's a beast. CJ Anderson is a beast. He cannot be stopped. Y'all, let's get it. Oh my goodness. There's no way. Oh my god. Okay. CJ Anderson just broke by like 6 million tackles. He's a beast. Man, he's trying to first down. Oh, spin him. Oh, trying to be a little CJ Anderson.
Down here in
the God, this is a beast. Feed the beast. Don't let him get caught. Now feed the beast. Look at the beast. Oh.
He's averaged about 2 yards a carry on the day.
Got to give a lot of credit to the defense. They were calling over the run that time.
Hey, I'm running to stay up the middle. I see a little hole to the right in the middle. Now I say, go. See a little hole. I'm in that hole. So the Broncos defense cannot get stopped. But they can, but the Denver Broncos offense can score every single time.
You have to like what this team has done today, passing the football. It's been their identity this season, and that continues here today.
Yeah, like, listen, this quarterback is a lot like a pitcher. Some days he'll beat you with the fastball. The next day it's the breaking ball, and that's what he can do,
oh,
too.
My God!
Brings it in for the score.
Cody Latimer! Cody Latimer! Second place! That's the second time in the exact same place. He's a perfect dot. Dot perfection. I bet the head coach is going to be really glad about that.
And they did it with a blistering aerial attack.
Go.
Quarterback is hot. He is getting protected. Oh, man, what do you do now? I think if you're an offensive coordinator, it doesn't matter what you call. You know your guys are going to make it work. Well, he's in the NFL because of this. Because this guy can break tackles. Good job on that play.
Little Ziggy out. There we go.
Second and 2. And Daniels has got
the catch. That passer.
Third catch today so far.
I think the coach on the sidelines, he's going to be happy with every first down because he knows that's more time off the clock. When you're up like this, multiple scores in the second half, every first down just puts the odds in your favor of winning this game.
John Franklin cannot be stopped. He's a beast. 12 yards after contact.
They bring in the extra tight end. Now first and 10.
Go.
Stands in the pocket. Has the reception all alone.
Oh, beautiful dot to Demaryius Thomas. Same reception, 43 yards, and reception for Demaryius on the day.
There's not much you're going to get done then. That time, quarterback had time, and throws it down the field for another completion.
Locked in on the football and has
Andre Caldwell. That thing.
Good job that time by the offense. They pick up a first down inside the 20-yard line. Now we'll see if they can punch it in and get 7 points.
Putting that rock. Look for CJ Anderson on this little out route.
second half.
Breaking huddle at the four.
Trying to get this goal. Drop touchdown. Get points stuck out. Looking for these little short routes right here to be over. There we go.
First touchdown of the season. Phil did. The Broncos offense takes the
Broncos
field.
Deep.
Do is not get anybody hurt. That's right. Get this game over with in the NFL. And that's a touchdown late in this one. That.
Here we go. Mike Zimmer, whatever his name is. The Minnesota Vikings coach is devastated. Teddy Bridgewater has hatred on his face. This should have been an easy game for the Denver Broncos, but the game, it was actually a little bit closer than it was supposed to be. Even though the Broncos scored 63, they scored 17. Still, it should have been an easy game for the Broncos. Defense is kind of slacking first, second quarter, third, fourth quarter, they stepped up, got some stops, some key stops on like the 1 yard line, just fed that thing to CJ Anderson, he dove in for a touchdown. One inch touchdown. Boy. We probably made it the best. Oh, boy, I'm ready to play in the game. And I fed it to the man's house. And he cut it up field for like a almost touchdown. But we were up there a little bit more. A lead pass.
Let's go! Red 38! Red 38!
Oh, let's go around. Let's go around steps around the league. First and
say goodbye when they ask was a word for you to pay. For my music, for press and play, for all the stress that went into my songs, my love and hate. The most honest I could be with you to date is to say thank you, Shady, for letting me be me with no holds barred. Thank you for the chance to enhance this old car, this old drop. And there's but two fine lines on a blank sheet, but so far these two lines point directly to my home on the mothership sonar. Valet UFOs, I go par. Dirty South needs a soap bar in the mouth of these MCs, but who am I to judge on what they love? I guess they enjoy being broken co-stars. And I'm soaking so hard from the sweat that I could take my clothes off. The whole yard should sit back and shake the dough off. But I'm already gone. I got a vision like tele songs in an envelope like letters, letters, green, money, loan. Wolf packs in the cow's home. I keep making these albums. Yeah, you might have heard a dial tone, but I was on all the line when I hung up the phone. I send a postcard when I leave. Dream. And when I'm up under the high beams, I reflect that shining. So you feel the heat of light and life of fire, the sun of dying. Yeah, I've come a long way from Dixieland. Take my hand.
Talking about John Franklin throwing 5 touchdown passes.
Everybody, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. As we head towards kickoff, two quarterbacks will be on the field today trying to push their teams to victory. It's the Raiders going up against the Broncos. Now we'll head down to Jim Nance and Phil Sims for this Week 5 matchup.
It's the NFL on EA Sports. Kickoff looming in this AFC West matchup as we join you from O.co Coliseum.
Hello, friends. Jim Nance along with Bill Simpson. You just have to love these types of games because there's just so much bad blood. There's such a deep rivalry here. The spirit is intense, and these teams will do anything to beat the other team.
Well, they will, and we know that. It's just more attention to the details for the players during the week. And also, you got to be ready for trick plays. The coaches, they want to try to fool the other team, give their team an edge. So you got to be ready for fake punts, fake kicks all during the game.
And Sebastian Janikowski looks ready to get this one underway. Talib's the deep back for the opening kick. Broncos ready to go on the march again, and that's exactly what they've been
Huffman
doing.
Huffman was putting John Franklin for first quarter. Maybe some beef.
Last two possessions for touchdowns. Phil, can they make it three straight?
Let me say this to you, Jim. It's just not that easy. As we're watching this game and how they're playing on the offensive side, they make it look easy.
That's his third
catch of the day.
That's a good job by the receiver. Run the drag route across the field. These are not easy throws for the quarterback, but he sticks it right on him for the completion.
Owen Daniels makes the catch.
You got to be able to adjust when you run these drag routes across the field. The throw cannot always be right on target. Can you reach behind, make the catch, and keep going full speed? That's the sign of a good receiver.
Gonna try and scramble now. Got a big lane. And the tackle is made at the 48-yard line.
That's an excellent job by the quarterback getting a few yards there with the run. You know, when you play against him, of course, anytime he drops back to pass, you've got to be alert for the run.
Snap it out of the gun. And now he'll take off. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Always be alert for this quarterback to run the football when he gets the chance. He is excellent with it. He is a quarterback with the abilities of a running back.
The Broncos will take the snap from the 45. That's a gain of 10.
If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
They come to the line, and it's first down. Ball lines up in the backfield.
Running away from the pressure. If you give him the chance, he will run the football. That's what he did that time. He tucked it in there and ran up the field and got a few yards.
The Broncos come to the line. Of course, plenty of pink on the field today and in the stands, as all of October we'll be seeing this for Breast Cancer Awareness Month in the NFL.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. Welcome back. Halftime just a couple of minutes away as we resume play at the two-minute corner. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down.
Nice job that time by the offense. Get the first down inside the red zone. And it's a good thing they got a quarterback with a strong arm, because you've got to throw into some tight spots in the red zone.
They'll go shotgun here. Looking at every option. And they're all over him for the sack.
Here we go. CJ Anderson, go. Come on, CJ.
Anderson's going to secure the handoff. And that's a gain of 9. He's now averaging 6 yards a carry on the day.
Well, when you get inside the 20, Jim, sometimes it's hard to throw the football because the defense is not worried about defending the whole field. So that's a good solid run. Picks up good yards on first down.
He'll take the snap from the gun. In his hands, complete. Touchdown. Time, and with that touchdown, they have a little extra breathing room before the break. The Broncos offense preparing to get this drive underway. Their last drive actually ended in a touchdown, Phil. We'll see if they still have it in them to issue a repeat performance.
Well, what you saw in that last drive was everything just came together perfectly for them. The experience of the football team, the talent of the players, and the coaches helped them out, and they got it done. Defense is about discipline, and when you lose discipline, big plays happen. That time,
the defensive pass rushers a little overzealous. They get out of the rush lanes. The quarterback gets outside and makes the play.
Back that time, in on the tackle. The Raiders defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. We'll go nickel. Is complete.
A lot of things change in that locker room at halftime. You know, you might feel good about what you've done. Of course, you got to realize the defense might be upset and is willing to come out here and take more chances in the second half. When you back up, there's just so few plays that you feel comfortable running. That time, nice job by the play caller. Gave the offense a chance, and they picked up a big first down.
First and 10. He brings it in. Has 12 on this play.
Good job by the offense here with a good lead in the second half, picking up that first down. And that's what you want to do. Take your time, look at the play clock, take it down as low as you can, and keep picking up those first downs.
First down and 10.
By the receiver, getting past the yard markers, makes the catch and gets the first down.
Yard line.
All right, coaches, don't get greedy. Be decisive over there on the sideline. Do what's best for your football team. Keep getting those first downs and letting that clock just keep running. You got a big lead here in the second half. Don't take any chances.
An extra tight end on the field for this one. The final quarter underway now with this snap. Takes off. Makes the catch in the end zone. Touchdown.
Welcome to the stream.
The Broncos offense heading back onto the field to start the drive after the result of their last possession was a touchdown. Do you think they've got another one in them, partner?
Oh, I absolutely do. I mean, just look at it. They've got a good football team. The quarterback has great confidence and talent. And you put those things together, that makes you good. It makes you dangerous. And I wouldn't be surprised to see him march down there again. I think the coach has got to call more of these plays. That's a good job of at least trying to get the big play, but they cannot get the completion on that long throw.
Second down and in a very precarious spot. The Broncos lined up in the pistol. Anderson's lined up directly behind the quarterback here. And it's Jordan
When you're on the defensive side in a situation like this, you know the offense is going to be limited. Be aggressive, get up there at the line of scrimmage, and try to make it happen. That time they did it, and they stopped the run for just a short game.
Third down and 8. He's thrilled as he throws.
The Broncos put themselves in a situation where the defense has all the advantage. They know the pass probably has to go down the field on third and long, and they are ready for it.
Position thanks to that punt, and now
the Broncos offense comes back onto the field. Let's see if they can move the chains this time, because the last possession was ugly. They weren't out there very long.
Jim, you know how I think in situations like this, I think it's more to the coach than the player.
He's forced to the ground.
The offensive coordinator's just got to make some adjustments here. They can't stop the defensive line from sacking the quarterback. So either keep the tight end in or keep the halfback in to help block for the QB.
The Broncos will take the snap from the 35. He's scrambling now. Sanders has got the catch and the first. The catches have come in bunches for this wide receiver, Phil.
Good job by this wide out today. He is finding a way to catch the football.
Yeah,
let's also give credit to the offensive line for pass protection and the coaching staff. They have done a tremendous job of coming up with different plays to find different ways for him to catch the football.
To Daniels. Allen's going to make the tackle.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
Anderson takes it across. It is a touchdown. This.
The Broncos offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. That was a solid touchdown drive.
Now just look at them, Jim. The way they run onto the field, you can see they're exuding confidence. When you've got a confident football team, man, let them go and let them play and see if they can make it happen again.
As you look at the numbers, and they're impressive, it's business as usual for this quarterback, Phil.
Another big day, another big stat day. Jim, I just can't relate to these numbers.
Danielle's got an injury update for us. Let's go to her now.
Guys, I just spoke with a Broncos official. He was able to confirm that his injury involved.
Makes the grab. Touchdown.
In addition, the staff won't confirm an exact timeline for his return right now, guys, but he will be dealing with this injury for at least a couple weeks.
Will decline the penalty.
He's on to the...
The Broncos took care of business. business here today, Phil. And now you've got to think they just want to run the clock, avoid any injuries, and get to that locker room as quickly as possible to celebrate.
They got out here today. They wore out this defense. The offense was absolutely tremendous. And you're right, don't make a mistake now, like a penalty, whatever. Let the clock run out so you can celebrate.
They have the lead, and this spread offense and aerial attack has been the difference maker.
Well, every coach wants a quarterback who can get it done. I'd say the guy here today, Jim, he had an outstanding day, and he got it done. What a performance.
Third catch today so far.
The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
First and goal from the four. And they get the sack. Second down coming up. Out of the gun. Muscles through the defender. Scrap, and they score again here.
Oh, it's good. He didn't be right. Cut the stone. The other is keeping it tight. Tight.
My goodness, Phil. So for Phil Simms and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nantz saying so long for now.